Good evening, this is Kuro. Got another black game in, well, a ranked game with black. Going over the matchmaking, looking at enemy teams has a Jean Bart, Double Musashi, Buffalo Black, and a Kitakaze. My team is running Triple Musashi, Neptune, and Double Black. And I went on ahead and I pulled this video as it's a really good example at just staying ahead of the curve, ambushing your enemies, and basically maintaining the initiative throughout the battle. And there's a lot of stuff in here that I think that can help a lot of people. I'm going to try to break down as much of it as I can as I'm going along. So my initial deployment, right here you see me checking out different guys, just seeing if they've got camo, seeing, you know, what's going on. Try to get a feel for what kind of player they are, just by taking a look at their ships. Are they, you know, running dead flags, or, you know, is it something that I need to be worried about? Hey, get off the blinds. Number one's still up, and she's, rampaging through the house. So, right here, my game plan is, I want to push up into this area. I want to torp between these two islands. I know they've got a radar cruiser, and this big island is a pretty common radar position, simply because it's pretty damn strong. Enemy force detected. So I basically pushed up here, threw some torps back in there, and then I'm just gonna rotate over to this island, and you can see my concealment circle is extends well beyond it. This is a repair bonus. There's going to be a lot of pressure to pick this thing up, because whoever gets it, especially for a DD, it's, you know, it's hugely valuable. RPF is telling me that, you know, a DD was there. I catch the Kitakaze. And if you look, when I zoom in, he doesn't have his guns on me. I go on ahead, I take the shot. And I actually get off two shots before he even gets shots on me. And that helps me win this trade. He's also shooting AP because I was broadside. So as soon as I angled, he stopped really doing heavy damage to me. In the meantime, Kitakaze, he's been chunked down to about 50%. You'll see him pop up here in a minute. There he is. He's hurting pretty good. And this is giving me, I'm going to pause it right here. This is what I was looking for. You look at the enemy ship spotted near me. You got a Kitakaze that's relatively low health running. You've got a black that he's under fire. He's running right now. There is a buffalo coming into the island. Not sure if he's under fire or not. He's not spotted at the moment, but I'm going to take this moment of, confusion on the enemy team. Basically the ship's closest to me. They're confused. They're running. They've got a bunch of problems going on. I'm going to take this opportunity to close the 2 kilometers and go ahead and pick up this cap. I do get radared by the buffalo, but their Kitakaze gets radared as well. So me pushing out here, I'm just getting some shots in on their buffalo, or their Kitakaze. And since I'm detected, I'm just gonna go ahead and keep shooting this buffalo. I was trying to juke that, but he just hit me square. I'm gonna have to repair my engine, and just gonna duck in behind this island right here and try to mitigate the damage. And there we go. Islands are your friends, destroyer players. Islands are your friends. So this was pretty cool because my team picked up an early repair here. I picked up a repair there. So now I have three repairs on my DD, and you can see the effect it has on my HP. And this is going to make me a bit of a monster to deal with. Now, right here, I see a play coming up. I've got a Neptune that's pushing the flank. I've got a reload consumable here. I've got my torps up. I've got a bunch of ships in behind this island. So what I want to do, I want to rotate up here by this island, and I want to dump torps straight in behind this island. Basically harass anything sitting behind that island, because I mean, what's gonna stop me? A low health Kitakaze? I've got smoke, I've got radar, I've got my tools available to deal with a destroyer. And in the meantime, I'm just gonna set my sights on this repair and come up here and hook up with my Neptune and maybe be able to pull something off. And when I say something off, what I'm thinking in my head, we spot the Musashi. I'm basically going to, and I'm just going to flip this around so you can actually see. I did this based off the mini map. But I go on ahead, I pop smoke, and you can see I just catch the island and I just lay a. Hello.
Enemy cruiser sunk. Off to a great start.
I just run that smoke right out for my Neptune. You can see what I'm doing right there. And because I'm ahead of the smoke screen, I'm able to keep these battleships spotted. And got some good things going on. Switching back to my gun view. Originally, I thought that
Smoke screen
five
set.
torpedo hits is more than enough to kill the Buffalo. Originally, I thought that I might have clipped a battleship or a destroyer in there. I see the smoked up DD shooting. The gun signature tells me it was a Kitakaze. Just throwing radar out there. Let's get some damage on this guy. And right here, the way I'm driving, if you notice, I was detected by this battleship, but I basically steered back in this way. Well, back more towards there. I basically put this island between me and this battleship. This battleship's behind the island. And now, the Kitakaze's inside smoke. This battleship now is behind the Kitakaze smoke screen, and I'm able to stealth fire. So being aware of, your surroundings can save you a lot of hit points. Just throwing out a couple blind shots, make this guy feel it. Musashi had poked out. Just gonna repeat it. Throw a couple more torpedoes back there, and just keep shooting this guy. If he keeps backing up, he's probably gonna hit those torpedoes. If he goes forward, he's gonna have to push right into a Musashi that's just waiting for him. And this is what I mean by seizing the initiative. I've basically forced this Musashi into a clusterfuck. He's either gonna push into this crossfire between this Musashi and this one, or he's gonna eat my torpedoes. One of the two. And I'm taking a look right now. It looks like the Musashi's headed forward. Well, you can't actually see it, but he's going full speed ahead. And he just gets wrecked. My smoke's just now wearing off. And I'm just coming back in here, just keeping this Musashi lit. This is, nothing fancy. Just want to make sure my team's got vision. That Musashi, he gets hit pretty good. I see this black up here. I've got radar, I've got smoke. And I'm just gonna start helping myself to this black. and try to chunk him down for my team. I should have slowed up a little sooner, and so I'd be able to actually stay out and be able to shoot. I do start backing up, and just gonna throw out my radar. I'm backing up, and looks like the Black's engines are busted, so I know I'm gonna catch him. His repair is down. And again, really feeling, you know, the benefits of that triple repair party. I could make a play like that and not even give a shit, because it's just coming back that much faster. So throwing some shots out there on that Musashi, throw some torpedoes out there. Right now I'm just trying to line up, use the circle on the mini map to kind of see where that guy is, see if I can land some hits. At the end of the day, I've got bigger fish to fry. I've got a Kitakaze floating around out there, and you know, I'd just as soon figure out where this Kitakaze is. I do see the Musashi, and he blunders right into one of my torps. And at this point, I'm just creeping out here and gonna help with the Kitakaze. And that's gonna close out this game. And, you know, like I said, this game had, it's not a high damage game, but it was definitely a high impact game where I was where I needed to be to help my team out. And, you know, I hope you guys enjoyed this game. If you have any questions about why I did particular things, leave them in the comments below. And I will do my best to answer them. Hope you guys are having a good night, and I will talk to you later. Beautiful.